Did you ever think for a minute it would get this far on the internet? Or, I mean, why do you think it has gone this far?
Lying. Anne keeps lying, that's why.
Mm-hmm.
Revenge or something. For, I guess it's a dream story for conspiracy theorists or whatever. She can't possibly back down now.
No.
And be proved a liar. She has to keep going.
Mm-hmm. And do you think, what do you think Robert Greene's part in this has been? In how?
Well, he just likes the publicity, doesn't he? It's very...
I think he's been used as a puppet.
Yes, just likes the adulation.
A muppet.
Now, well...
But he's been duped and hasn't would never admit that, would he? But he has been.
Absolutely.
100%.
I think quite a few people have been duped by it. That's
yes.
part. That is part of
yes,
it. It has been a story that's captured
yes, that's
people's
right.
imagination.
People would find mm-hmm. it hard to believe that anyone would lie.
Yes, to that extent.
Such a horrendous thing.
Yeah.
I actually felt sorry for Robert Greene.
Yes, most folk
court,
did.
He just came.
He was just a lost soul. I mean, even he won't believe it now, but he can't do anything about it. He's caught up in it. But after all that evidence, he wouldn't believe it either.
He does, though.
Yes, but I never thought about it because it was just a lot of rubbish. I never thought
anything would happen.
Anything like this would happen. I thought she would have recovered and become all right. I didn't realise that she was still mentally ill doing this.
What effect has this all had on Greig?
Devastating effect. Absolutely. He is heartbroken. That's a boy that is missing his mum. Something terrible. And he's made numerous tries to get her to contact him. He's heartbroken, he really is. And it's affecting him really badly. Well, you didn't know who had received letters. You didn't know who had spoken to how many other people. You just never knew if you were being judged or... it was awful. Not knowing what people were thinking, if they were believing the Cod's wallop or if they were, sticking by you and thinking what utter rubbish.
And what Robert Greene's defence was, this type of thing?
Well, he didn't have any defence. No, there wasn't any defence for him.
He was too desperate to know who was Masons and who wasn't. Just so ridiculous.
No, there was just days and days of evidence that proved that it never went on, and Hollie has never been sexually abused.
And the pathologist was
yes.
a brilliant witness.
Yes,
I mean,
he
spelled it out in every detail how it wasn't possible that he'd been beat up and whiskey poured down him. It was smoke inhalation, and if that had happened, his lungs wouldn't have been filled with smoke because he would have been dead before.
So
I mean,
the pathologist clearly explained
he explained it
absolutely
brilliantly.
Yes, he did.
And anybody who could believe the rubbish after listening to him.
Yes, well, that's what I mean. Belinda and Robert sat through it, and so they know the truth.
Yeah, the people who received letters were in court as well, saying what they believed when they got the letters, and most of them just knew it was a lot of rubbish, which was good to hear.
Reassuring.
Yes.
What do you think about the people or groups on the internet that have taken it further and...
Well, they don't know. They don't know the truth. They only believe Anne, which, why wouldn't you? They don't know that it's a lot of lies, so
I don't feel anything. They just don't know. Like the people in court in London. None of them knew that it was lies.
You spoke to one of them, didn't you?
Yes, I did. One lady. And she questioned it. But whether she believed me or not.
Do you think that there's been a lack of investigation into the facts before people started claiming it all over the internet?
Well, there was no investigation. That's why it is as it is. No investigation by Anne's friends. Plenty investigation by the police.
Yeah. The police investigated it twice, isn't it?
Oh,
twice,
I'm sure they've investigated it lots of times.
They're sick to the teeth of the whole thing. It's cost a fortune. How many man hours? You can't even begin to think. Shocking that the Scottish taxpayers or British taxpayers have got paying, what is it, half to nearly £1 million in absolute nonsense. And why would 22 people go to court and perjure themselves against one female who's spinning loads of rubbish? 22 people wouldn't go and lie, would they?
No. But this is what some people say, there's a huge conspiracy involving the paedophiles, the police, the sheriff, the Freemasons, the BBC.
Absolutely rubbish.
It's either that is what's happening, or else Anne is telling lies.
Anne is telling lies.
Absolutely. There is absolutely no doubt. And they're evil lies. Evil.
Because she's just insanely jealous of everybody. She's really never got over the fact that she has a Down syndrome child, really. It just affected her so much.
It's sad, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It is sad.
Yeah. I don't think Robert has been punished half enough to get a year's sentence and toodle off home in 3 months is bloody ridiculous. We've had 2.5 years of hell. And I think Anne seriously needs sectioning again. And,
yes,
and
she does.
Holly needs to get a life, even though it's just temporarily, to be in a normal environment and file Anne's being assessed or whatever.
Is there anyone else you hold sort of responsible for this situation that's developed?
Mrs. Belinda McKenzie, I think she's a...
Well, the strange thing is, after sitting through 2 weeks in the court with all the evidence...
Every day.
Every day, writing it all down, she still believes... she doesn't. She couldn't possibly.
She couldn't.
She couldn't possibly.
She's the intelligent woman she's supposed to be.
But she still claims it to be true.
Have you ever had any contact yourself with Belinda McKenzie?
Yeah. I've spoken to her, yeah. Because on one of the days in the court, they showed videos of Hollie and Anne. And what she put in her blog that night was that a certain two or a week,
us, yes.
we couldn't stand it anymore and left the court.
Which was untrue.
Absolute lies. So the next day, when I was outside having a cigarette, I said, "Excuse me, can I have a word?" And, "Yes." And I said, "I'm not very happy about the lies you've put on your blog." "What lies?" And I said, "We sat through that day in court right till the end, and you've said that we couldn't stand it and we had to go." I said, "That's absolute lies. We were there." "Oh, well, I was told." I says, "But that's a problem. Everybody's told, but they didn't work it out for themselves."
But she left the same time as us. We went out to court the same time as her. So she knew
it
was a lie.
She must have known it was a lie.
Yes.
And she did remove it and said, "Oh, they must have been out for a ciggy break," which made us sound a bit like plonkers, but never mind.
Yes, Sylvia, why did you go down to London?
Because I was going to London, so I went a day earlier just to go to court to see what was happening to Hollie. So
I did.
And a concern, really.
Yes, to see what was going on with her.
And what faced you when you got to the court?
Oh, just a bunch of undesirables.
Did you feel threatened at all?
Well, they tried to threaten me, but no, I didn't feel threatened.
I think I would have.
Was it... And what actually happened in the court that day?
Well, they adjourned for lunch just as they were about to start, so we all had to move out of the courtroom for an hour's lunch break. So I went down to the reception and went to go up again to after the lunch, but there was a group of Glaswegian girls waiting for me at the top of a stair, so I decided not to. So I didn't actually see what went on in the court. But one of the officials told me once it was finished, because I waited till it finished, and he said that the case had been thrown out, obviously. She didn't win her case.
You didn't sit behind... Did you sit behind Hollie then?
No.
No.
Didn't sit behind her.
No.